What up, people?
With Charles Davis, as always, I'm Brandon Gaudin. Charles, you talk about storylines in this one. I think it begins and ends with our two quarterbacks, certainly two of the best in the business.
And nowadays, I don't think you can get by for long periods of time without a top-flight quarterback. The way the game is played, with all the responsibility he has and how the game flows through him, if he's not...
All right, we're 2-0, so we got to get these things going. Let's get it.
A clash of two of the more fervent fan bases around. The Cowboys and the Raiders are underway. And not much on this one. Takes it from the 21. They're going to take this up close to the 40, so really good starting field position. So here's a first and 10 at the 38. They'll start by running the option to the right. And he gets this to the other side of midfield across the 45 before going out. The drive starting play, a good one. Give him 19. And this, I mean, it's certainly something to watch out for. He is not afraid to call his own number on plays like that. And here he takes it for good yardage.
And we know this defense prepared all week for this, but sometimes when you see it in person, it's a whole different ball game. And all that preparation, it goes right out the window.
They'll go option on second down, right side. And he'll lose yardage here, back at the 41. That's a big loss of three, and it brings up third down. Play action. It's Fields.
And this one is the best.
Touchdown, Cowboys. Dave Casper, 41 yards. And the Cowboys will claim the early lead as they're on the board first here tonight. Well, they had gone run the previous play. Nice little setup. This time they go play action. Defense bites a bit, and they hit for a big play in the end zone.
So they sold it really well, didn't they? Because of just what you described, they ran it the previous play, come back with the same action, and now they step back and throw it and get a big play for a touchdown. But what happens as a defensive back is your eyes have to go to the right place. You always hear Coach talk about, are your eyes in the right spot? But this time the eyes went to the play action. It froze their feet. They weren't moving. And he went on past them and caught the pass for a touchdown.
And up to about the 26-yard line, just across the 25. They'll bring a tight end in motion left. On first down, Fields. And he's going to have to eat this one as down he goes. Now following the sack, they'll come up here on a second down and 12. Back to throw, Fields. They'll find his man, LaVisca Chenault. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. Solid gain of 18 and a Raider first down.
And that's a more than acceptable read right there because it's zone coverage. So timing is everything. This time he waits for his man to come open, puts it right on him, and they pick up a first down.
Now on first down, he'll drop to throw it. Completes it to the tight end, Kittle. And they're going to get this to about the 44-yard line.
An ex-teammate used to tell me all the time, I hate experienced quarterbacks because no matter what, you really can't hide what you're doing. And I think that right there, he knew right away where the blitz was coming from, where his primary guy was going to be, and he ended up going to a secondary target for a nice game.
I was just
going
to ask you, that wasn't the primary target, and he's so good at that, isn't he?
I think he knew right away that he wasn't going to get to his primary guy. I think he read that as soon as he got to the line of scrimmage, knew where the pressure was going to come from, and said, I know to beat that, and that's what he did.
Carry for Josh Jacobs. And brought down, but not before they're inside the 25. give them 12 yards that time at a Las Vegas first.
Usually we see runs like this as the defense breaks down later in the game, but this guy is setting the tone early, running through all types of tackles and put the defense back on its heels.
On first and 10, here's Fields. And he fires one incomplete.
Well, a momentary speed bump there with that throw, partner. The defense had other ideas, and they're trying to mount a small stand before this drive reaches the end zone.
Back to the air, Fields on second down. This one into the hands of Kittle, the tight end. And they're going to get this down inside the 15.
Was not quibble about the gain there on second down. That was a positive play because that was a take what you can get situation. Got out to the tight end. Now gives a much better opportunity to convert on third down.
Here's Fields. This will be caught by Brown. Touchdown. Britton Brown. A 14-yard touchdown. And the Raiders respond to that opening drive touchdown with one of their own. Decent hands out of the backfield. That's the first time, Charles, they targeted him in the passing game, and it pays dividends.
And I love the design, too, because they kept him in the backfield, made the defense think run first before they swung him out of there. And you're right, with his hands, they might want to throw it to him just a little bit more.
It's complete. And did he get the football to break the play? No, he did not. They'll say he's out of bounds, shy of the goal line. And they'll be denied on the two-point conversion. On is the Raider kickoff unit now as they will send this one away. And not much on this one. Takes it from the 21. And they're going to start this drive in pretty good shape as they get it up past the 30. About set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense. The offense running out, and they are charged up, ready to go after reaching the end zone on their last drive.
And normally I'd warn against getting complacent just because they scored the last time out, but I don't think there's any worries with this group right now. This is a hungry group, and they want to keep building off of their last drive. Now they just want the officials to hurry up and place the ball so they can snap it and get back to work.
Now he's going to get this all the way down inside the 35. It's a gain of 34. Defense blitz, but they picked it up pretty well.
Allowed their man to stand firm in the pocket and not be hurried, didn't it? That allowed him to make the nice throw downfield to help complete that play.
He'll buy some time right.
Got him.
All right, rifles one, and that's going to be intercepted.
Smart play.
Picked up by Keanu Neal. And the Raiders are going to get the football there as he gets this up to the 38-yard line.
He's been having a good day so far, but I think he got a little overzealous on that one. Still young in this league. Has to learn to try not to do too much on an individual play because, as we all know, sometimes less is more. And throwing away is preferable to making the big mistake.
And he's going to be out of bounds right at midfield. Give him 13 yards on the opening play of the drive and also give him a first down.
I like how they worked the tight end on a nice little under route there. And if you're going to give him that much space, he's not even going to catch the football. He's going to run away from you a little bit. And that's exactly what he just did there, picking up extra yardage.
In motion left here, one of their tight ends. Here's Jacobs on first and 10. And he'll get this into enemy territory, but not by much as he's down to the 48. Credited with a one-yard gain there to make it second and 9.
Well, sometimes you just have to give credit to the defense. Great job there at the point of attack, holding up. They won their battles at the line of scrimmage, left him no space to try and run. A really nice job swarming to the ball carrier.
They'll bring one of the tight ends in motion left. They just do get the playoff as he'll look to throw. This caught left side by the tight end Parham. And he's got this down a yard or two shy of the 40 before he's out of bounds. And that's good for a gain of 6. And now it's 3rd and 3. 2 minutes remaining in this first half of football. A good chance this is 4-down territory if they're unable to convert. But right now looking at a 3rd and 3. In motion left goes a tight end. Trying to run for it with Jacobs. Oh, that one well designed as he'll take this down to the 30-yard line. Give them 12 yards that time at a Las Vegas first.
Well, partner, what do you think? Might have been four down territory if they didn't pick it up, but...
Yeah, it's a moot point now. I was curious, so if they didn't get it there, would they have gone for it? I guess we'll never know.
Yeah, we didn't have to make that call, but I have a feeling both of us would have said, go for it.
Fields throw pulled in by Kittle. And he stopped right at the 25 after a gain of five.
Such a tough position to defend near the line, even when you add a second defender. But the big man shrugged off the extra body and made the play call a success.
Second and five. Back to throw. Fields over the middle. He's got Chenault. And he's going to have another first down here as the tackle's made at the Cowboys' 12-yard line. 13 yards as the quick slant keeps the drive moving. From down at the 12, it's first and 10. In motion left comes Brown. Back to the running game with Jacobs. And strong running there as he's inside the 10 and down to the 8-yard line. The Raiders going to use one of their timeouts as they stop it here with just under 40 ticks to go in this first half. They'll bring a receiver in motion right. Second down, Jacobs once more. And this carry not as productive. He swallowed up at the line of scrimmage. No gain on the play, and it's going to bring up a third down. Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense. As the clock will stop with 20 seconds to go in the first half. An 8-play drive to this point. So here's play number 9 on 3rd and 7. Operating from the gun, Fields to the end zone, but knocked away and incomplete.
What an excellent defensive stand there in the red zone. Nice tight coverage. They certainly recognized how important it was to bring up fourth down here.
Scoring on this drive was crucial.
And they jump back in front here. It's 9-7. So, Charles, they get to them with their first turnover of the game and then make it hurt a little bit extra with a field goal.
And anytime you give the ball up, what's the first thing a coach tells his defense? Don't let them score off of this. You've got to put out the fire. In fact, in 2021, that's what one NFL coach termed his defense. The firemen, go out there, guys, and don't let them put some points on the board.
About set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense. And with only 9 seconds remaining, with not much time, we'll see how they play this. And a throw right sideline is complete. And he goes out of bounds just shy of the 45. We knew he was close to the line of scrimmage, and they say he stepped over.
When you see him in that position, you think he's become a runner. As a DB, you start to react towards the line of scrimmage. They can often throw it over your head.
So the illegal forward pass also costs him a down, and now it's second and long. A final shot before the break. Fields rolling to his right. Now on the run, he'll throw it back deep over the middle. Oh, that's into a double team, and it's intercepted. And he will be brought down.
Had to sell it like it was open. I knew he had to throw it deep anyway. He was going to get an animation. So I had to bait it off.
So we've hit intermission. It's halftime. This is the NFL, and it's a presentation of EA Sports. Now underway. This will be fielded inside the 5.
And out a little across the 25 to the 27. The Raider offense set to get this drive started. Now this game, it has obviously been all about the defense on both sides of the football. Which offense is going to break through here? We'll see if they can do it on this drive. And he'll take this up near the 35, maybe the 34. 7 yards on the pickup there, and it'll leave him with a second and three. They'll bring a tight end in motion left. Throwing on second and three. Fields. And it's a short one here, complete to his tight end. 4 yards the pickup, first down.
When the offense reads blitz, doesn't matter where it's coming from, tight ends know that they become a big part of the passing game because they should be an easy outlet when all those extra bodies are trying to get to the quarterback. A hot route, so to speak.
And not a whole lot of room to operate there on the first down run. He gets maybe three.
Not a huge carry there on first down, but not all of them will be. But still, all in all, a positive play for the offense. It's all about picking up at least a few to set up what you're going to do here on second down.
3 yards on that last carry. Here's second and seven. Moore, the man in motion. From the 41, Fields. And this one incomplete. Too much contact to hold on to that one, and it's third down.
I see the surprise in your face there, partner. That is a rare incompletion from him. He's been on point this entire game.
He has percentage completion-wise way up. Not that time. From the gun on third down, Fields. Got a man, and he hits him in stride. And he's going to have the Raiders' first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
We often hear the phrase sure-handed tight ends, and he certainly fits into that category. Plus, he's got a quarterback who knows to look his way when they need a big pickup. And on this play, he finds it for the first down.
In motion right is Brown. Here's Jacobs from the gun. And he'll go down, but not before getting this inside the 30. 59 yards rushing now on 8 carries for him so far. They'll send a receiver here in motion right. On first down, they go with Jenkins again. And inside the 20 before he's brought down. A good gain again, and that's now 31 yards combined on those last two plays.
Looks to me like maybe there's a little attrition setting in with this drive. Because when you see that type of a run, I get the feeling the defense gets a little bit tired.
And that's the last thing they need, especially when they look up at the scoreboard. So the ball down to the 16 here for first and 10. In motion left here, one of their tight ends. Once again, it's Jacobs. And stepped a few yards shy of the goal line at the 3. Back-to-back nice gains. That one for 14 yards and another first.
Well, you certainly have to give a little credit here because they're playing this game now at their pace. This is ball control football, sustained runs, taking their time, and making it work.
Here's Jacobs. And he's in. Touchdown.
Good hit.
Josh Jacobs, a 3-yard touchdown run. And the Raiders take the opening kickoff of the third quarter.
Use that pass game, open that run game up. Now we got him in the zone.
Right down the middle, and that makes this a 9-point game.
And we hit the third quarter up, so that was great. True possession game, we get the ball back. Even if he scores.
Not much on this one.
I think I got the perfect strategy.
They're going to wind up with pretty good starting field position as they get it out past the 35. About set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense. Well, the opposition laid down the challenge at opening drive touchdown here to start the second half. And Charles, now you feel like this group needs to get an answer because this all of a sudden is a 2-score game.
Yeah, you're right about that. What was a small, manageable spread to overcome
a little bit more daunting now. I think you're exactly right.
Burn with fucking A's, bro. What the fuck?
Back with a chance to really extend this lead out.
It's a gain of 34. And as they come to the line, they will not be able to get off another play as time has run out on this third quarter. You are watching Madden Ultimate Team on EA Sports. Off play action, Fields.
Gotta get out in front of it.
There is he'll make the diving catch. To throw is Fields. Throw out right, take it in by Patterson. And he's brought down right at the 5 yard line. Give him two on the play. On second and goal, Fields. And it's caught.
That last adjustment on the field.
The Cowboys have made it a one-score game again here in the fourth. They'll give it to the fullback up the middle, and he will get into the end zone. So how about that for putting it on the line? They've taken the lead by a point here in the fourth quarter.
Team expecting it, they do actually recover the ball, which is what we saw here. I just wonder if that number is much more of a anecdotal type of a number. Kind of like when the coaches tell us, well, when you score on special teams, 93% of the time you...
And he will score. Touchdown, Las Vegas. George Kittle, 35 yards. And the Raiders are able to build on to their fourth quarter lead. So these two teams matching each other score for score on this last touchdown. That bumps the lead back to 7 with the extra point to come.
And it's a heck of a way to play, isn't it, partner? You feel good about it because you continue to keep the lead and your offense keeps scoring, but you sure would like your defense to make a stop.
And he's got it. So the two-point conversion is good, and they add on to their fourth quarter lead. The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. And not much on this one. Takes it from the 21. And they'll be set up pretty nicely here as they have it up to the 35-yard line.
And just slow them down. And that's some poor lives.
About set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense. Well, that last touchdown we just saw, what an important one. Now it's back to a two-score deficit for this crew as they take the field here. And they are in. He's got a man. Complete. Touchdown. Marquise Brown, 65 yards. And the Cowboys have got it back to within a score.
No, we're not cheering. No, we're not rooting. But I am excited about this. I know you are, too. We got a ball game again after that big-time strike.
Big-time strike.
Good stop. Let's go.
Don't go anywhere yet. This thing's not done.
Shit, big man.
And he is not going to get in here. So the decision to go for two does not pay off as they're unable to cut any further into their deficit. Now after the touchdown, here's Gonzalez on to kick it away. And a short kick taken at about the 16. And taken down just past the 20 at about the 21-yard line. The Raider offense set to get this drive started. After the touchdown we just saw, we have a brand new ball game. And now look at the situation. You've got plenty of time on the clock. Defensively, they have 3 timeouts. So do you run the football here or do you throw it?
I think you have that full conversation with your offensive unit. You tell them, here's the situation. They've got all of their timeouts. So we are not going to play this conservative way. We've got to attack them. We've got to make them use those, gain the ground that we need in order to put this game away. If you think we're just going to run it 3 times and punt it, you got nothing.
Call me, go
by. And by the way, also the 2-minute warning in play, so essentially 4 timeouts left.
They have to be aggressive.
And he literally has no inside stuff. None.
As he has gotten better, really, as the night's going on.
points. Yeah, he doesn't have no run stopping abilities.
2 minutes left to go in the fourth.
Not totally. Gotta have at least one, bro.
Looking good as they come up first and ten. The man in motion is Brown. They'll stay on the ground with Jacobs, and he'll be brought down right on the 50. A gain of three.
That's just a pile of bodies there, and that's when you kind of find out who's a tough guy, right? Who can stand up and make a play. It's only a three-yard run, but for both sides, they had to walk away from that field like, okay, I can stand
still up. Jacobs.
It gets tough in here.
And past the 35.
See, this is what I would look like if they gave Jacobs abilities and Regs. Yeah, I like that. Yeah, he knew he couldn't stop it. Use that quick pass game. He had to worry about it the whole game. And then it just, boom, opened the run game up wide. I was getting 10 yards of carry to help get him in the zone. He knew what time it was. That's three rage quits in a row. We are 3-0 now, fellas. Convincing. Like, that was our toughest game. But other games, bro, they just can't stop what we got set up for ourselves. Pretty good strategy. I like how I'm using it. Like I said, I'm going to probably try to incorporate some of it to Regs a little bit. I'm probably going to have to improvise on certain situations in Regs with manual subs so that I can get better pass blocking when I need it. I'll probably have to sub in like extra linemen as tight ends because Regs, you don't have the same blocking that you do in Mutt. But other than that, you know, I basically got a blocking tight end and a receiving tight end, but my blocking tight end just so happens to be a good receiver too. So that helps. And it works, you know. End of the day, that's what you
with
want.
Charles Davis is always.
We're going up against another good team.
Charles, you talked about storylines in this one. I think it begins and ends with our
team. We're coming up in the world. We're coming up
to the business.
And nowadays, I don't think you can get by for long periods of time without a top flight quarterback. The way the game is played, with all the responsibility he has and how the game flows through him, if he's not on the top of his game, your team's not going to benefit at all.
The kickoff unit is out on the field and they will
feel like this team can do it.
Very short kick taken right at the 20. And he's only going to make it to the 13-yard line.
The fact that he did that.
For most people, the excitement of the kickoff return is to see a ball
that
goes
steps.
Back in the opposite direction. But for the guys covering it,
he's been able to
step
them deep
in their own territory. How about that incredible form tackle right there? Shoulder in the ball carrier, and down he goes.
Going to start to drive here on the ground with Patterson. And he gets up near the 25 to about the 24 before going out of bounds. 11 yards there on the first play from scrimmage. For one unit I know you want to watch is that offensive line. If they keep clearing holes like that, it could be a long night defensively.
No doubt about it, because when they are in sync, as we're seeing so far, when that continuity is there, and you can see that they're playing off of each other while controlling the defensive front linebackers, you're exactly right. It could be a very long night for the defense because someone's going to run for some big yardage.
Now the result here, a pickup of 8, leaves him with 2 to go on second down.
A nice run here early on. It doesn't take a great play caller to realize you want to establish a guy of his caliber who runs like this early because they'll pay dividends as the game progresses.
They'll send Moss in motion right. Second and 2. Open man is the Hall of Famer, Dave Kasper. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. They'll look to throw now on first down. He'll get that to his
that's an illegal block.
On the move past the 40. Big strides. Look at him go.
A big play there on the catch and run. 52 yards. We know he's good at catching the football, but then after the catch, he's got escapability.
Not only that, he's got some toughness as well, because you know he's coached very hard to make sure he battles through, breaks tackles, and then they finish with, but don't fumble the football.
They'll let the fullback try and take him home. And he'll keep working toward that end zone as he's down to about the 2-yard line. And they'll turn to the power game to try to get in. And he is into the end zone for a touchdown. Christian Okoye taking it in from 2 yards out. And the Black Knights put the Knights' first points on the board as they take the early lead. Zane Gonzalez on for the extra point. Oh, this is blocked.
We don't know.
Going the other way. Look at this. Middle of the field. A breakaway. 30. 10. 5. And he takes it the distance across the goal line for 2 points. So after all that, it's just your everyday 6-2 ball game.
And let's think about how important that can turn out to be, because remember, it's not just a 2-point swing. It's a 3-point swing. I'm just wondering, you think they can load the bases and hit a home run and tie it up?
Well, I was going to ask you, I can't remember the last time that I've seen a 6-2 score in football.
Me either. I've been racking my brain on that one. 6-2? Not often.
Now, here's first and 10. And now we're going to get a timeout here called by the defense. They'll have 2 remaining as we step aside here in this first quarter. Start the drive, and he'll get a few yards here to the 34.
They suspected it was a power play up the middle coming at him, and boy, were they right. That defense got downhill in a hurry and limited them to just a couple on first down.
And push the offense backwards a bit. Here's Fields. It's intercepted. Chauncey Gardner-Johnson back, and they take over. They'll set up shop at the 46-yard line.
And that's a great example of ball skills right there, partner.
Yeah,
you've been through a lot of games, and I can't tell you how many guys look to run with the football before they've intercepted it. So that's a nice job of focusing on the task at hand and coming away with the interception.
That's a room to run now. And he's going to be out down inside the 20 at the 15. 50 yards rushing for him now as he has gotten the night off to a hot start.
I don't care what the game plan was coming in.
That.
After these runs,
you're running it, right?
you make sure you keep circling on your play sheet, running plays that are working, and keep patting those big offensive linemen on the back. They're doing a great job.
It goes without saying the defense is going to have to adjust it.
In a big way, and they've got to figure out, do they have to sell out to stop the run, or can they just do it better than what they've done so far?
Tackled by Isaiah Simmons. Here's 2nd and 9, just a yard on that last run. Now back to throw. This is caught. Touchdown.
That's what he's trying.
Casper from 13 yards out. And they're able to add on to their advantage.
We're still in the first quarter, but it's apparent they're going to have to come up with a different defensive game plan for him, because right now he's kind of having his way against that defense and has added a touchdown to the list. How do you slow him down? They're going
to mix up some coverages, maybe change who's guarding him.
After the field goal, here's Gonzalez to kick it off. From a yard or two deep, here comes a return. And the decision to come out of the end zone is going to cost him 5 yards as he's taken down right at the 20. The Raider offense set to get this drive started.
As the offense comes out here, Charles, maybe perhaps a bit more of a focus on the run game for this drive after tossing an interception on the previous one.
I think that's a good way to look at it and a good way to think about it, but maybe they get to it in a little bit different way, because after you throw an interception, you want to make sure you keep your quarterback's confidence high. So maybe give him a couple easy throws that he can complete and then get to the running game and try and get things settled down.
Yeah, it's still in the first half here, a long way to go.
Moore, the man in motion. Buying time to his left. And Fields going to have the first down before sliding to a halt to avoid the contact. Back-to-back good plays have him on the move on first down. They'll bring a receiver in motion right. Forced out to his left. And Fields going to have the first down before sliding to a halt to avoid the contact. Another nice gain. That's now 30 yards between those last two plays. Moore, the man in motion. Fields on first down. Being chased out left.
Why would he go forward, bro? Like, I don't need him to go forward.
That complicates things a bit here. 18 yards to go now on second down. Eluding the pressure right. Well, that'll be incomplete. He took a shot as he let that go. And it's going to bring up a third down.
I know he was trying to get the completion downfield, but the way this game has gone, with a few of the runs he's made along the way, he should have kept the ball and taken it with his feet downfield. That's the big play that shreds the defense. Instead, he thought to himself, I'm a quarterback. I've got to throw it. He bailed out the defense with that incompletion.
Oh, ball batted in the air, and now it's intercepted.
Yeah, man. I got to get a better tight end for these better teams.
Stops just a little bit shy of
Kittle's good, but can't get him running mid routes.
So that now two consecutive drives that have ended in interceptions. You wonder if he's trying to do a little too much out there.
Oh, I like where you're going with that, that maybe he's pressing it a little bit, trying to be too fine with his throws, or maybe overestimating his arm. It could be a combination of all of those things. In any event, he's got to get it figured out and in a hurry.
They'll come out throwing here to start the drive. That's caught by the Hall of Famer, Casper.
Man, tight coverage.
At the 40-yard line. A first down carry by Elliott. And nothing doing. He's immediately taken down at the line of scrimmage. Tremaine Edmonds there to bring him down. So after the run for no gain, here's second and 10.
As usual, the hallmark of a good run defense, linebackers making plays near the line of scrimmage.
Under a heavy rush, and down he goes. The Raiders going to use one of their timeouts as they'll head to the sideline and talk over what to do next.
Dust in my
He's
corners, bro.
Fuck! It's the tight end, Casper. Touchdown! Dave Casper with his second touchdown here in this first half. The
I don't have an answer for Dave Casper yet, man, but we will eventually.
Gonzalez good on the extra point, and the lead is up to 18 now. Now after the touchdown, here's Gonzalez on to kick it away. This one fielded at the 5. And he'll get it up just past the 20 as his guys will go to work at the 21-yard line. The Raider offense set to get this drive started. As the offense comes out here, Charles, remember they threw the interception last time out, but they were moving the football down the field. Looked like they were going to have a sustained drive that ended in points, but then the pick ensued.
And because of that, there's no way you can call the last drive a success. Yes, there are things to build on because they found some play calls that worked.
Come on, man.
Build another drive and find a way to avoid the turnover that plagued it on the last one.
From the 21, it's 2nd and 10. They'll bring one of the tight ends in motion left. 2nd and 10. Fields again.
That's it. Yo, how is the corner behind me?
Sauce Gardner puts it off, and he'll take this down inside the 15-yard line. Boy, Charles, that is now 3 interceptions in 3 consecutive drives, and you can see he's just got a look of disgust and bad body language, understandably, as he walks.
How does the man pick it off from behind? Look, body flipping.
When he sees down the field,
this game disgusts me sometimes.
He just can't read defenses. I'm not sure what it is, but that's why he's frustrated. Think about the defense right now. Every time they run on the field, they've gone from hoping to intercept the pass to expecting to intercept the pass.
Take pride. My defense does have good run defense, so we can build on that.
Wind up a loss of a full 3 yards on first down. Second and 13.
I can't play contested. Well, I gotta get those 90 pointers, bro. Shit. To the point where Gilmore is not able to cover the better guys anymore. But he can do that for me at least.
Set to get this drive started, and with a 3-score deficit staring him in the face, they might have to press the issue here and try to get points out of this drive. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. Now the Raiders going to go ahead and use the 2nd of their timeouts.
No, he plays man coverage. I can scramble with my quarterback, so I'm going to build off of that. It gives me an advantage.
40 already, and another 1st and 10. Fields is intercepted for a
team beat his man.
Sauce Gardner picks it off, and his guys have got it back in the closing stages of the first half.
Is Sauce Gardner the best man coverage corner?
You throw the interception. Not only that, you do give it to them in plus territory as well.
Yeah, they were pushing real hard to try and get something more on the board.
Well, they're out running a little off.
Looking at it with 20-20 hindsight,
though,
might have been better to hand it off a few times, hoping to get something to break instead of putting the ball in the air and, of course, putting the ball in jeopardy.
This is brought in by Casper. And he'll be brought down on the other side of midfield at the 43.
Let's just call it what it is. This has been a flat-out struggle for this defense all game long. They've really had a hard time slowing them down. And while I'm not big on speeches and guys jumping up and down, they might need their team leader on defense to get in their face right now and light a fire under these guys. They've got to start playing better assignment football and start getting guys on the ground.
Back to throw now on first down. He'll take a shot for the end zone. And it's caught. Touchdown. Dave Casper on his way to a monster game. Three first half touchdowns.
That's just nothing for it right now. I'm going to have to make some upgrades, but... I think skillfully beating me, he's just beating me with abilities and better cards right now. Match up with the same team, I'd probably blow this guy out. It's not really using any skill plays.
If they decide to kind of squib kick or what they're going to do on the kickoff, because you don't want to give up a big play right before the half ends.
Good point.
But I'm going to remain with my $0 spin. I'm not going to be enticed to buy anything in this game.
So 6 seconds, all that remains of this
I can get it up there eventually.
The kick is away.
Couple days in, 4 days of work, 5 days of work.
Outside the goal line. And no alley to be found. The coverage was solid, and he's dropped at the 18.
No, you pay for your team, bro. I spend $0, bro.
From the safeties, they are all over the field. Doesn't matter if they threw it or they're trying to run it.
I don't think we've ever awarded an MVU most valuable unit, but you're right. It might go to them in this game.
I like that. MVU. Well done.
Oh, this will be incomplete. The rush gets home just as he was letting that go. That could have been worse. Instead, it's fourth down.
The frustration is definitely setting in because they've thrown it to him over and over, unable to come up with a catch thus far.
I think he knew he would have his challenges against his secondary. I don't think he saw a goose egg at this point in the game. He'll try and run for it. And this will depend on the mark. I'm not sure he pushed the line forward. And indeed, he did not. They stop him. The Raiders try it on fourth down, but to no avail. And this defense will take over right near midfield at the 49-yard line. Now a play fake here on first down. And that one drops down incomplete. Good coverage there. Force the ball free, and it's second down.
Oftentimes when you're losing the game and the team's still throwing with this kind of a lead, you start playing a little more physically. And they took that opportunity right there to be extremely physical and force that incompletion.
4 yards the gain, and it'll bring up a third down.
And that was a good collision right there. And I know this as a former defender. If you're playing linebacker, you're going through a checklist on every play on who you think's going to get the ball, where you think the ball's going to go. Rarely do you expect the fullback position to get it. And on that play, he did. So you got to steel yourself at that point because the contact is going to be strong.
Nowhere to go here. He lost the football. And the Raiders pick it up. And nothing but green grass here, middle of the field. And he's into the end zone. It's a fumble return for six and a touchdown. And at this point, after that return for a touchdown, I guess the only thing is you're asking what else could go wrong.
Not only that, I think that between the two of us, we thought this was over before. I believe now it's really over.
Following the fumble recovery, Fields. That's caught. And he will get into the end zone to cut the lead a little bit further. I guess the last score wasn't enough for him. They want more. Here comes an onside kick. And they've got it. They recovered it. But hang on now. There's a penalty flag down. I guess they felt like they needed something to get them going. Maybe you wait for this type of a play, but they try the onside kick, and it works.
I'm starting to wonder if the analytics coach is starting to get involved in the football nowadays. When you see this type of play made, this type of a risk taken, sometimes there's different influences going into the head coach's ear.
And he goes out of bounds. It looks like right at the 50. Nice work to get 7 out of that, and it's second down.
But this has certainly turned into a showcase game for what he can do on the ground because they're just continuing to give him chances to run it, and he's earning every additional carry by putting up positive yardage on each run.
From the 50, here's Fields.
And he's got this down a yard or two shy of the 40 before he's out of bounds.
Fields, we know he has the good mobility. He flashes it there as he scrambles for the first down. Now it's Fields.
And he's got his man on the out route.
And he's going to be marked down just inside the 35.
Looking to throw again on second down. Fields. And they're going to move it down to inside the 25. Shotgun handoff to Brown here. And a good run as he manages 7 yards down to the 17. And they're not going to get to the line to run another play. So we will switch ends as the third quarter has come to a close. You are watching Madden Ultimate Team on EA Sports.
3 yards remain for second down. A shotgun snap. Fields. Are going to have a first and goal coming up as the tackle made at the 3-yard line. From the gun, here's Fields.
And he'll take it into the end zone for a Raider touchdown.
Justin Fields, a 3-yard touchdown run. And the Raiders get a small.
first time on this drive we saw him take matters into his own hands, and this time he finishes things off with a touchdown run.
You're not going to be happy with me, but I think he took matters into his own feet, didn't he?
No. Davis from the top rope. I like it. And they're going to get the two-point conversion, caught in the end zone, and that cuts the lead a bit further.
Incomplete.
too tough to hold on to that one. It's second down. He did an okay job of absorbing the hit, just couldn't secure the football through the catch.
And he was right there on the spot and forced the incompletion. That's something defenders work on all the time. If you're there, make the...
And he can't find a receiver, and he's brought down. Isaiah Simmons getting by the offensive line and dropping the quarterback.
This is a little hard for me to compute because I'm watching sack after sack happen, but somehow they're still behind in the game. I would expect all this defensive pressure to translate to them taking the lead. Thus far, it hasn't happened. Time's winding down, and a one-way sustained performance from these ace pass rushers.
On third down, Elliott. And he's going to be taken down right at the line. Call it no gain there, and it leads to down. And now with 1:52 to go, we get another pause in the action. A timeout here defensively. They'll drop to throw. And it's incomplete. They cannot convert. And they turn it over. The fourth down pass play doesn't work out. And the Raider D, they get the football back. The Raider offense set to get this drive started. And this is intercepted. And that should do it. Picked off by Stephon Gilmore.
Brandon, they're down here in the second half. Want to try and make something happen. And if you're the guy with the ball in your hands, you're going to try even harder. Because I think all he was trying to do was to get outside the pocket and see if he can find a big play downfield.
Now it looks like he'll throw here. On the run, he'll let this go deep right side. And it's nearly an interception, but it's incomplete. A turnover really would have helped him there, but not to be. An incomplete pass on first down. That leads to a second and 10. They'll try to run some clock now with Elliott. And he's across the 40, 3 extra yards to the 43. 4 yards the gain, and it'll bring up a third down. They are in need of 6 yards here if they hope to move the chains. Looking to throw. And that is incomplete. Oh, he had a defender right there with him to force that to the ground. And fourth down now coming up.
That's an excellent job right there on third down. Like any defense, you never want to let them get anything started. And that would have been a first down. Instead, you saw the contact on time, no penalty. And before this drive could get wings, it's fourth down.
Here's a play fake as they set up to throw. Nowhere to go here. He lost the football. Pick it up. The 20. And hold everything here. This one is not over yet. They return it for the touchdown.
They continue to fight, don't they?
This defense, Charles, they needed some type of a spark to help get them back in this game. I think they just got their spark.
No doubt about it. You know, that's all they discussed. How can we get ourselves moving again? How can we get our team going? This definitely qualifies.
And this is going to be recovered by the hands team. And that should just about put a camper on this one. A big mistake in that spot. You got to let it go, Tim.
They didn't give themselves a chance. They had an opportunity, touched it first. Now they're in a really bad spot.
Victory very much in sight now as they'll take a knee. Now the Raiders going to burn their third and final timeout.
Yeah, you're the one that sucks taking a knee. Fucking bomb. Almost gave up a 40-point lead. Pussies take knees.
Let's see what they have drawn up here. A little bit behind the line. 12 yards needed to gain a first down. Now contact up front as penalty markers come in. Who is this against? So jumping from his free safety spot.
That tells you how aggressive they are on defense, doesn't it? They get everyone involved. He was a little too fast on that play.
So he'll take a knee here to wrap this
this one up, and he's going to want to keep that game ball. He was sensational. Well, taking that knee, maybe just a sigh of relief. They withstood a big fourth quarter comeback. Able to hold on, though.
Certainly looked like they had things going their way, didn't it, in the fourth quarter? They had to just hold on. As you said, furious assault on them. And they were able to get it done, take a knee, and head to the locker room with a win.
We almost did it, man. We almost made the epic comeback, bro. Jesus fucking Christ, bro. Man, that whole stack team started talking shit, and then out of nowhere, bro, we make a weird, drastic comeback. That's crazy. I'm different in the fourth quarter. When people start saying I suck and shit, it's just like it just builds the fuel to my fire. He had some good man corners. I'm not even gonna lie. Like, second half, it was all me, bro. Like, I shut him down. You know, but other than that, like, dude, I'm not gonna take away whoever his cards were. He had that Chauncey Gardner. That motherfucker played some good man coverage. I can't lie. I don't know what ability he had on him. If he was just cutting my routes off, I should have probably put DJ Moore on the inside. Chenault's not going to get away from that. I killed myself in the second half just throwing picks. I was forcing that. Like, if I didn't beat myself in the second half, the second quarter, like, I got forced that. I probably had to open. I could have just took a quick tight end. Probably start using that one more. Really didn't have an answer for Dave Casper, bro. Like, everything, like, I'll have a guy on him. He's just too fast. Like, I couldn't get. Probably what I'll do is I'll swap my safeties so that I could put Merrick on the tight end, I guess. So, it's Gardner, bro. I ain't gonna lie, man. The man's out there is just, he different. Like, his man coverage was, like, they got that motherfucker's big. Way bigger than DJ Moore. I might have to go look at his size. He had the Justin Jefferson 89. So, I mean, he had good receivers across the board. You know, 89 DB versus 89 receivers, 50-50 roll. I saw his Gardner roll. Like, dude was just, he different. Like, this one kind of, like, questionable, because he was behind my receiver. He clipped through me. Like, that shouldn't have happened. We started making some good plays. Defense came up, got some sacks. Dude, his guy's in man coverage. Like, he got fucking Ted Hendricks just outrunning my tight end. You know, obviously my tight end isn't fast. That's why I said, if I can get an upgrade, it would be nice. Like, if I want to go further down the field. I think I forced a sack. Because when I shouldn't have got sacked here, I was just kind of waiting for something to develop. I should have hit that slant. I actually had the touchdown right there coming across the field. But he stopped. I don't know why. He wasn't going to let me throw. Like, if I would have hit him, like, right there, probably could have had the touchdown. But I don't know. He went up instead of going backwards. I was trying to get away from him. Parsons with the big boy play. Who was that, mate? That's our team captain making the stop. Fucking Adams. He's good in that 3-4. I'm not gonna lie. Put that inside stuff on him, and he's getting a lot of sheds. So when they play under center, that's been pretty good for me. And Pepper's in that contain, bro. Like, contain and mutt is different. Like, it's going to get, like, if he's off outside, you take one step to him, bro, he's getting off the edge. Like, that's, I'm going to start using that more. And we caught him with the crosser. We had to send that tight end deep to get him. And we started piling up them sacks. Forced that pressure. Everything was covered downfield. I started playing man, but I put both corners in outside quarters, and I was trying to get my inside underneath shades with hook curls and curl flats. Like, I probably put like a seam flat on one side, on the weak side. And then I put, you know, a hook zone on the strong side. Just trying to figure out ways to take away those two digs that he was running. He was running like a drag and a dig. Wasn't sure exactly. I'm trying to find a play where he was using it. Just, you know, I started getting these sacks. So he started blocking one side. He ran a crosser, so it was three route concept. I think as far as the zones I was using, I had the hook zone and the outside quarter on the right. And it just kind of took his slant away. And I used it on Casper to stay out in front to help the other safety get on him. And that outside quarter on the other side, so he wasn't going to beat number five. And then we had put Parsons in man coverage, I think, on the tight end. As you can see, he went to the flat with him. So I kind of just trying to get a little creative with the coverages that I had on the field. But like I said, took the loss, but we use it as a learning experience. Just got to slow the game down when it gets like that, man, instead of just trying to get frustrated and people be like, quit. I don't quit, man. Losing and then adjusting is what's going to make them better. Was good. We almost had a 40-point comeback victory. We took the first loss right there. We got our four wins. We just need one more to get to the Super Bowl. Learning a little bit more about this 3-4 odd. Kind of using it as a base principle, like anytime they come out in two wide receiver sets. And then that's probably what I'm going to start doing in Regs as well. But I'm going to have to change up how the personnel looks in Regs, because you need fast guys that can cover and speed rushers on the edge. So I don't know who the Raiders have outside of Diablo that can do that for me. But we'll figure something.
With Charles Davis, as always, I'm Brandon Gaudin. Charles, you talk about story.
Probably get creative with like the D-line subs and stuff.
With our two quarterbacks, certainly two of the best in the business.
And nowadays, I don't think you can get by for long periods of time.
But that offensive scheme, you know, you just got to change and adapt based off of how the game's playing out for you. And you're not always going to do the same thing every play. But, you know, sometimes you might change a route. You might add a blocker. You know, and just kind of take what the defense gives you, just kind of adapt and adjust a little bit.
This one taken just inside the 10. And he had no room to run as he's tackled down inside the 20.
You're going up against that same guy. And, yeah. Good shit, Adams. Yeah, it's the same dude.
Officially a loss of two on the first play from scrimmage. Second down.
When people talk about plays being blown up, that's exactly what they're talking about. That's Exhibit A for physical play.
On second and 12, Fields. And that is in
the lead.
A lot of force bearing down on him there. He could not hang on. It's third down.
No surprise at all. They're looking for the big man early in this one. The only surprise for them, he couldn't hang on to the pass.
Three and out, a real danger here on their opening drive as they come up on a third and 12. Fitzgerald coming in motion right. Throwing on third down, Fields. He gets it into the hands of Larry Fitzgerald. And he'll be out of bounds near the 30. In fact, right on the 30. A really nice pickup of 14 yards, and it moves the sticks. One play action, Fields. Knocked away. It's incomplete.
This is going to be the matchup to watch out on the perimeter, and it won't be the last time these two go at it. Both of them believe they are the superior. In this case, the win goes to the defense.
They'll send a receiver in motion to the right.
Big nickel's probably better for the motion heights.
Throwing again on second and 10, Fields.
There we go.
Into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted.
So this guy had a real bomb, yes.
Take possession of the football.
Well, they certainly weren't afraid to let it fly early, and they hope that'll keep the defense honest and keep the offensive guys excited about getting back out there. They are in attack mode in this game. It did backfire a little bit. Now you just hope your defense...
It's the last time he had those man coverage.
So you're not facing a deficit the next time you run out there.
So we're going to adapt to it this time, kind of. Go more off of it.
An inside give, Brown. And he'll manage to pick up about four at second down.
Nice jumping yards on first down. It really opens up your options for what you want to do on second. You go right back to him and hope he explodes or sucker the defense in before throwing over the top.
First carry for Josh Jacobs. 7 yard.
Nah, bro. You better take this L. Yo, that's exactly right. You taught that shit in that last game. Then second game, you're going to rage quit. Fuck out of here. We'll take it, though. All right, we're on the playoffs. We got to win two to get to the Super Bowl. My team not super, bro. My mind is. So I gotta win, what, 3 games in a row? It's not an easy task. Oh, EA, come on now. Y'all got to do better than that.
Certainly two of the best in the business.
And nowadays, I don't think you can get by for long periods of time.
God Squad versus a zero money spent team. Let's go.
He has and how the game flows through him. If he's not on the top of his game, your team's not going to
benefit at all.
You need to be real smart.
On is the Raider kickoff unit now as they will send this one away. Very short kick taken right at the 20. And he takes it all the way across the 40 before going out of bounds.
As they say, if you drew it up, you couldn't have drawn it a whole lot better. That's exactly how you want to start the game. Excellent momentum off the opening kickoff.
Get him, Hendricks. Let's go.
And he can't get rid of it. He's taken down. The Stork Hall of Famer, Ted Hendricks. Give him the credit for the sack and a loss of 14 yards. But just two plays in, and Charles already their first sack defensively.
Yeah, how about that? That didn't take long, did it? And now they look at third down, and that's another time to try and go and get the quarterback, too.
Let's go.
Under pressure, they got him again. Julius Peppers, yes, he still has it. Give him the sack. What a great job getting pressure here on the first drive. Three plays and already two sacks.
And that pressure has been intense right from the beginning. And I'm telling you, if they don't make an adjustment in play calling and protection, it'll go from intense to relentless.
Good work bringing that one back as he picks up about 16 on the return. And it'll be Raiders football first and 10. They've got good starting field position as they come up here first and 10 at their own 42. Back to throw, Fields. And incomplete on the deep ball.
I may be an analyst, but I'm also a fan. I love it when people take the big shots downfield, but he was under a lot of duress. And I think that forced the incompletion downfield. Didn't have a real good chance to find his target.
Flush to his right. He's going to look deep for more.
Oh, my God.
Good effort there trying to take a shot, but it's third down.
Scramble drill. That's my first time, bro. I ain't been done this game mode.
Attempted to do on that one, unable to connect.
Fields. And that one a little too high as it's knocked away and incomplete.
Give them credit for excellent coverage, tight coverage. They're doing a lot of things that we talk about in basketball. They're causing disruptions in the passing game. And as long as that continues, it'll be tough for them to gain any momentum throwing the ball downfield.
Step aside here in this first quarter. In motion left goes a tight end. Fourth down, Fields.
Good user. Oh my! Bro! I can't be dropping them.
The 20, and he's going to be out. inside give to Elliott. And he'll get about three just outside the 10, stopped at the 11. The last run got three. Now here's second and seven. Here's Fields.
That's it.
As he releases it, and that'll fall incomplete.
Part of what we're seeing so far is the defense is certainly coordinated. Both levels doing their jobs in tandem. The back helping the front helping the back. The pressure got home on that last play and forced him to try and throw through contact and short of the sticks.
Now Fields.
The tackle.
That's complete. Just a gain of a couple there. And that's going to make it fourth down.
Excellent job there defensively. Gave up the underneath to the tight end on third down, and they made sure that they did their job. Got him on the ground and prevented him picking up a first down.
Gonzalez's kick is good, and the Lions are going to take a 3-0 lead. So after drive number three here, we have a score, and it's 3 points after the field goal.
I would say the feeling out process for both these teams.
Well, so we missed that one play touchdown.
Now you've kind of proved a little bit. Now you want to start throwing the big shots. First 3 points up on the board could be significant.
Pulls it in at the 13. Now he brings us out past the 20 to the 24. The Raider offense set to get this drive started. They're coming off a fourth down gamble that last drive that backfired, CD, but really not as badly as it could. Their defense held up and only gave up 3 points.
And what they wanted to do is play off the momentum the defense gave them. Only giving up the 3 points in that situation after they failed on fourth down. Now they want to make it pay off. They want to pay homage to the defense and have their own drive pay off in points for themselves.
The run only got a yard. Here's second and nine. Fields now to throw. The first catch of the game for George Kittle.
Check it.
Past the 40 before he's out of bounds. 19 yards there on the catch and run.
When you get a big tight end like this, sometimes it takes more than one man to bring him down. Oftentimes, your best bet, just jump on and hold on and wait for your teammates to arrive to help get him on the ground.
Here's Jacobs on first and 10. And he's going to get it across the midfield stripe into Lion territory. 3-0 after one on EA Sports. On second and one, Fields looking for the out route. He's got it. Complete to Kittle. And he will go out right near the 35-yard line. 12 yards there as they keep this drive rolling. It's another first down. They'll bring a tight end in motion left. On first and 10, here's Fields. And he will find his man on the outside. And he'll be taken down at about the 22-yard line. There wasn't much of a window there, Charles. Had to deal with a couple of defenders, but able to find his big tight end.
And, partner, we know double coverage is a challenge for any player to try to defeat. But maybe it's a little easier if you're one of those big tight ends because you have a size advantage on just about anyone trying to cover you, and you use your body to create some space.
The loss of a full 3 yards, and now it's second down. Running straight ahead is Jacobs. And he'll get it down inside the 20 to the 18-yard line. That will go as a pickup of 7 on the 7th play of the drive.
On a second and long, it's really nice to see an offense that has enough confidence to run the football in that situation. I think that goes back to their practice and game planning. They've seen things that they've seen on tape and in previous games that led them to believe that even in a long-distance situation, they can still run the football and get...
They're looking for Kittle, but it's intercepted. Picked by Ted Hendricks, and the Lions are going to take
under pressure.
Definitely not the ideal time to see that mistake, partner, because this is still a one possession game, and that's at least a field goal that just vanished with that turnover. Now, pressure's on defensively to prevent that pick from turning into points for the other side.
And he's tackled a yard short of the marker. Good gain of 9 on first down. The last run got 9. That leaves him with 2nd and a yard.
Yes.
And this heads straight to the sideline. I don't think they're going to let him get away with that. Nope, they won't. Here comes the flag.
We saw it, too. Nobody in the vicinity of that throw, and that earns him the penalty.
Yeah, you've got to at least get it close enough to one of your own guys in order to dodge the penalty.
So now it's 3rd and long, because remember, they also lose a down on the grounding call.
Out of the gun, Fields.
Man open, he's got it complete to Cortland Sutton. And he is going to have a Lions first down as they're able to get the 3rd down conversion. This offense finding its legs now. Here's another 1st and 10. From the midfield stripe, they'll look to throw. And he can't find anywhere to go with it, and he goes down.
Max Crosby blowing up the play and getting the sack.
Sacks a growing theme in this first half. This is 2nd and long. Another try after the first down sack. Fields. He gets this one to Michael Crabtree. And he's going to have another first down as the tackle comes at the Raiders 39. McCaffrey running up the middle.
And he finds a little bit of room, enough for 4 yards. It'll be 2nd down.
The Lions will use the first of their timeouts, as the clock will stop with 33 seconds to go in the first half. The run got 4. Now they deal with a 2nd and 6.
To throw is Fields.
Oh, look at the catch there by the veteran Fitzgerald. From the red zone now, they'll look to throw.
He'll get this out of line here to McCaffrey.
To get this down inside the 15, either the 13 or 14, before he's out of bounds. Throwing again on 2nd down.
Fields. That's caught. It's McCaffrey again.
And we're going to get a timeout with 2 seconds remaining in the 2nd quarter. A bit of a surprise. They're going for it with 2 ticks remaining. No sign of the field goal unit. Now Elliott.
Yeah, he is. That's some bullshit.
Touchdown, Detroit. Ezekiel Elliott. As time expires in the first half. And the Lions will extend their lead on the final play of the half. Big decision there. They say forget the field goal and go for it. It pays off.
I wonder who was in the ear of the head coach on this one. Did he make this call on his own? Or maybe the analytics coach got involved. And a lot of times you talk about that all week before the game. Hey, if we're in certain situations, analytics actually says do it this way, which might be against the norm. And it paid off for them in a really nice way.
Cashing in and there on the final play in the first half. Are going to have it first, and they trail here as we get back to it in this 3rd quarter of action. Takes it at the 7. And he'll take it up past the 25 to the 26-yard line. The Raider offense set to get this drive started. Charles, it'll be interesting to see what adjustments this offense made in the locker room. Haven't really been able to get anything going offensively, virtually nothing in the ground attack either. So certainly something has to change here in quarter three.
And I'm pretty sure there.
The football comes out. Jacobs lost it.
Wow. Oh, boy.
But a teammate comes along and scoops it up. Almost like, it's almost like baseball. Guys at bat, people are on base in scoring position. One guy doesn't get them home, the next guy comes through and picks him up.
And avoids the turnover. The fumble on first down, now here's second down. Moore, the man in motion. On second and 11 now, Fields. And he will find the open man. It's DJ Moore. And they work this well upfield across the 45. Fields on first down. Completes it to the tight end, Kittle. And they're able to work this across midfield to the 48. 4 yards remain for second down. Here's Fields. He'll find his man, LaVisca Chenault. And it's going to be another first down as they'll get him to the ground at the Lions' 38-yard line. They'll stick with the passing game as he looks to throw. Trying to fit it in the middle, but it's intercepted. Picked off by the legend, Rainitsky. And the Lions will take over here as they get it up to the 43-yard line.
It wasn't the same shit. I tried something new.
Because after all their halftime talk, adjustments, and points of emphasis, their first drive ends with an interception. Absolutely aggravating if you're a head coach because you spent all that time, gone through every situation possible, and it still ends in a turnover.
The throw right side is complete here on the first play of the drive. And he's going to get this one down to the edge of the red zone. That one good for 37 yards. So a big play as it gets him all the way down to the 20 now for first and 10. Up the middle, here's Elliott. And he'll get this one down to about the 17. 3 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down. In the first half, he was held in check on the ground, but despite that lack of production, they still have the lead.
Yeah, and they've got to feel fortunate about that. If they could actually get production from their lead horse, that would help open up this offense and widen this.
And he takes this one in for a Lions touchdown. Ezekiel Elliott, his second touchdown of the night. And the Lions take the interception on defense and convert it into 6 points. They go with McCaffrey, and he will get into the end zone.
Really?
The lead up to 3 scores. And they're able to ground it in there on the two-point try. You and I were talking before the game. The two-point conversions from the 15-16 season, what has changed, what hasn't changed, partner?
Yeah, I'll tell you what's changed is just your normal strategy, because now you're either kicking the football with the ball on the 15-yard line, or if you decide to go for two, they put it on the 2-yard line. So what are you thinking as a coach? Do I risk it? Do I go for it here? Do I try and gain a strategic advantage and maybe go for two early? That's what people are wondering about.
The Raider offense set to get this drive started. As this offense takes the field against CD, remember last drive, they were moving the football, but then they... Oh, Fields is intercepted for a third time. Picked off by the legend, Rainitsky. Are going to take possession of the football. Well, still down quite a bit here, several scores, but yeah, at least that's a start, Charles, getting the interception here. And look, we're still in the third quarter, so this thing not done yet.
You're right about that, Brandon. This defense, they haven't quit on this game. They stayed with it and got an interception and handed the ball back to their offense. And what you wonder about is the team that just threw that interception, they've got to be careful about developing a sense of complacency and thinking this game is over.
Bro, Lurker, you're supposed to activate now? What the fuck?
But it falls down to the ground incomplete. So after the incompletion on first, now second and 10. The give is to Elliott.
I do. I use her.
Number two, maybe a full three down to the 32-yard line. Well, good field position to start the drive, but under the gun now here on third and eight. Again, it's
why?
And this effort will not get it done. He stopped well short.
Not to play run defense. I don't rely on abilities.
This defense not budging. Back-to-back carries of just 2 yards. Now Zane Gonzalez for the field goal try. Made his first. This now from 46 yards away. Gonzalez's kick is good, and that will extend their lead even further. So the interception.
I really don't feel like he's giving you good field position.
3 points, the end result.
Yeah, we can make this one pretty simple, partner. You always want that drive.
And that bullshit roll in at the end of the half.
And probably say we should have done better there.
This one taken just inside the 10. The Raider offense set to get this drive started. I kind of feel like they've reached a do-or-die point in this game, Charles. If they're going to try to pull off an impressive comeback, it has to start right here, right now.
Yeah, now they've got a final chance to get out of this situation, but they also understand they've got to move the ball and move it fast. In addition, they need to save as much time so they can get two more possessions.
We have played three quarters. You are watching Madden Ultimate Team on EA Sports. Now they're in some hot water now after that sack. It's second and 21. Looking to throw. Fields. And he's got his man in stride. Complete. A nice pick up there. 19 yards. And they're set up better for third. Back to throw. Fields. And he'll be touched down here, but not before he does pick up the first.
You do realize I got tight out, so you ain't gonna be able to play man coverage on my tight ends.
Looking to throw. Fields. And a quick throw here, that's complete. So give him 5 yards there on the pitch and catch, and it'll be second down. Throwing again is Fields. Finding room in midfield. And some room to work. And he will score. Touchdown, Las Vegas. DJ Moore. 61 yards. And the Raiders are finally on the board here in the fourth quarter. And nothing too crazy there. A quick slant, and then he just had a seam. He found a seam.
And when you hit it on the run like that, and I mean the pass right to the receiver who's already in motion and moving, sometimes he just takes it and runs away from everyone else.
And he ran it into the end zone. And the defense, they've got to adjust there quickly. That's tough on him.
That's really tough because everything was executed well. Ball was out of his hands quickly, into the hands of the receiver, and then he was gone.
Bro, y'all got to get that, man.
The risk reward of the onside kick. When you don't get it, the risk comes out to play. And here they gave up great field position.
And that's the key to everything because you're trying your best to press advantages when you have them. And field position leads you to that type of play calling. And whether you want to blitz or whether you want to throw the ball deep, those types of things, now that they've given up that type of field position, the advantage is switched to their opponent.
Again to Elliott. And he's going to take this ahead for right around 3 yards, but no more than that. Second down. And what do they start thinking about burning these timeouts? They've got all three still defensively.
To me, you have to start right now. Here's the time, and that means you've got to stop them on defense, not give up the yardage. Use your timeouts in order to get the ball back.
And he'll get into the end zone. Touchdown, Detroit. Ezekiel Elliott.
Need a better right end.
35 yards. And the Lions have put this one to bed here in the fourth quarter. So that drive there, CD, a good response, and that might be the one that gets him to the finish line, a comfortable lead.
Yeah, and that's all about not letting the team back into a game because they just gave up a touchdown. It was back to a two-score game, and anything can happen in that situation. But instead, they came through with a really terrific drive right there that ended in six. So you like the slam.
I was about to say.
Teams, in this case, are trying to block it as well. They attempted to fade to the back corner of the end zone unsuccessfully. And I've been with you long enough, Brandon. It's not one of your favorite calls.
Well, it's interesting. Before working with you, I always viewed that as you're just taking away space. And a mistake on the lateral.
Yeah, just run away after.
And I believe he was able to get this back. He was. Boy, after giving up the touchdown, lucky that didn't turn into another.
this in college, but I did it in high school. When you return kicks and you lose it yourself, the panic that goes through you.
And for the fourth time tonight, it's an interception. Picked off by the legend, Ray Nitschke. And the Lions are going to take
possession. That linebacker's hurting me right now.
This is one heck of an individual performance we're witnessing. That is now his third interception. And keep in mind, folks, this isn't a safety or a quarterback. This is a linebacker. Does this feel to you?
I got it too, but I'm just saying the linebacker is killing me because of that.
In high school, they were offensive stars. They touched the football all the time. It's like he said to himself, let's go back and put on the letter jacket and go get the football.
Yeah, I mean, I've got it, but.
Three interceptions thus far.
Second down and goal. Fields is going to get this one out to the back. And he is going to lose yardage here. They'd really like to make the short field pay off. We'll see if they can, but this is third and goal. Here's Elliott.
Good shit.
They showed a little athletic juke, but then the daylight quickly closed. They snap it to Fields.
Good shit, Gilmore.
It'll be intercepted. Picked off by Stephon Gilmore. And the Raiders are going to get the football here as the ball will come out to the 20. Trying to shake off the interception. He'll look to throw. And it's a short one here, complete to the tight end. And he's going to get 7 out of this before being taken down at the 27. From the 27, Fields. And
wow.
My goodness, another interception. Tariq Woolen picks it. And the Lions are going to take possession of the
ball. I don't know about that one, EA. He body clipped through him.
5 interceptions. What does this do to the psyche of a young quarterback?
Well, based on the fact that he's still out there and he threw a 5th interception, I'm wondering if his head coach believes that he's really strong mentally and wants him to play through it. Because otherwise, you need to get him out and play another day, because this could leave lasting damage if he keeps throwing interceptions. They are certainly not letting up on the pressure in this one. And oftentimes, you hear this expression, all gas, no break from defenses. But in this case, it's the offense still throwing the football up big in the fourth quarter.
Good shit, Parsons.
That's
some bright spots. My defense is all right. I just got to work for my offense a little.
Stop with 35 seconds left to go. A big play forthcoming. Here's third and goal. Now they'll throw here out of the gun.
Shit.
He's going to be taken down, sacked back around the 18-yard line. Now a second timeout called for by the defense. That'll leave them with just one remaining in this fourth quarter of play. Get to the football. It's blocked.
Now get up, get up, get up, get up. Go, go, go. Oh.
Some signs of life here, Charles.
Why?
In the big deficit, but at least they were able to prevent 3 more from getting on the board there with a nice block.
And that's how they're comforting themselves on the sidelines right now.
What up, Paul?
They certainly didn't execute well on that play.
Oh, they cheated me there. Well, he should have been gone.
They didn't need the 3, but they sure don't like giving up a block. Something to work on as they get into practice next week.
And this one incomplete. So the clock's done now with 20 seconds remaining. To throw once more on 2nd and 10. Fields.
Fucking animation, bro. If I pass lead 4, that needs to go to the sideline. It shouldn't be behind me. Ability or not. They need to stop that. That's crazy.
To the sun and had his wings melted. That was our guy right there. Keeps pressing it and pressing it. Finally, on that throw, he paid the price with that turnover.
Now a first down throw. Fields escaping the pressure right. That one complete to Okoye. And he's going to get a solid gain of 9 before being brought down. 2nd and right at a yard. action. Fields. And down he goes. Brought down a Raiders sack. And that will get a timeout here. They're able to stop it with 1 second to go in this game. Now it's Fields.
Tough loss. Damn, show could have won.
So this one's over. It's a win for the Detroit Lions. And I tell you what, I can't remember a defensive
performance. That sucks. Oh, they put me up against a stacked team. First fucking playoff game, bro. Like, it's like they're forcing you to buy packs. Like, that's one thing I've been noticing, so that's probably going to eliminate me. No, I got eliminated. Now we got to do it again. I got midfield. Take all these and put them into the cards. I can't put them in no sets. None of these eligible for any sets. Six train. Whatever. Oh, that was a tough one, man. Probably better off doing my... Try it again, man. Try it again. Oh, that was a tough loss, bro. Put us up against a stacked team. We tried to fight through it, but them better cards and man coverage, they tough. They not gonna let you just beat it.
With Charles Davis, as always, I'm Brandon Gordon. Charles, you
first game stack team.
In this one, I think it begins and ends with
it's like they do this shit on purpose.
Certainly two of the best in the business.
And nowadays, I don't think you can get by for long periods of time without a top-flight quarterback. The way the game is played, with all the responsibility he has and how the game flows through him, if he's not on the top of his game, your team's not
going Still, though, $0 spent. We're going to keep playing $0 spent.
Try
to make ourselves better.
This one fielded at the 5. And he's going to be taken down inside the 10 at about the 8-yard line.
Being on the road, the last thing you want to do is make a mistake that brings a crowd into it. Now you're not just battling your opponent, you're battling yourself as well.
Jackson looking to throw right away.
Good shit.
Takes a shot on the release as this will be incomplete.
They'll put a check mark in the box where the defense coordinator was saying, how well can we stay with these receivers if we're in man coverage? Because he just did it on that one. Force the incompletion. That allowed him to get bolder with his pass rush, won't it?
Absolutely. Frees up your guys elsewhere. To throw again on second down, Jackson.
Good throw.
Incomplete. Took a pretty good shot as he tried to pull that one in. Couldn't hang on third down.
My first thought is surprise, because that's one of the better tight ends around, and I've seen him pull in balls like this before. But how about a little credit to the defense forcing that incompletion?
So two incompletions have led him to an early third and 10. Here's Jackson. Runs over, and he's taken down, but not before reaching the 20. 12 yards is the pickup. Good for an Eagle first down.
And this is why trying to cover the angle route is so difficult. Anyone playing the linebacker position, when they see a running back out of the backfield widen because he heads towards the flat first, oftentimes you widen too much and overcommit. He cuts up inside, and that's what we saw there. That's a pickup for a first down.
And not able to break away this time as they're going to stop him right around the line of scrimmage. Officially nothing on that last run. They'll try again second and 10. Now here's the option play going left. And he will slide to a stop. He does have the first down. A nice pick up there, 10 yards, and it'll move the sticks.
I tell you, there is no antidote for speed, even at the quarterback position, as he keeps it himself and turns it into good yardage.
And it still takes time for a defender to react, even as quarterbacks carry the ball more and more in today's NFL. They're still a little bit in disbelief and realize, oh my goodness, he's running with the ball. He may be 8, 10, 12 yards downfield at that point.
Only able to gain a couple there, and it'll be second down. I think defensively you're okay with that. Here in the first quarter, he's going to get some catches, but they rallied to him quickly.
And that's what you count on, and I like what you just said. First quarter, can you do it all game long? They catch it, you tackle, they go down on the spot. Because when you're able to do that, you don't give up big chunks of yardage after the catch. Now you put the offense in a position where every series they have to work hard to pick up first downs, and you tend to stall them out when you do that.
Eighth play of the drive forthcoming, and they need 8 yards on third down. Jackson.
Good shit.
Incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect.
Man coverage is certainly a staple of their defense. That's built for plays like that, forcing that incompletion.
This is something.
That's into a sea of bodies, and it's intercepted. Isaiah Simmons picking it off, and the Raiders are going to take possession of the football.
Well, short of them returning it for a pick six, that was about the worst start you could ask for in this one, because your advantage of getting the ball first is gone, and they're set up a short distance from your end zone. Now you're counting on your defense to prevent a touchdown, and your offense, you better be ready to come out swinging on the next series.
First down, it's Fields. And this one is incomplete.
I'm going to need some help with this one. How did he miss it? Wide open in the end zone. He's not hurried. He's not hit. And somehow, incomplete?
Yeah.
What happened?
During film study, that's one where he's just going to shake his head, not be able to believe it.
6 points go by the wayside on that one.
This one into the hands of Kittle, the tight end. And he'll be taken down at about the 22-yard line.
Got to give credit where it's due. Really nice defense on that play. The pitch and catch was successful, but not any run after it.
From the gun on third down, Fields. Open man for him. He's got him. And he is going to have the Raiders' first down as he's able to get 8 yards there on third and five. After getting that turnover on the first drive of the game, you'd hate to just stall out the momentum, go three and out.
Eventually, he'll stop trying to blitz.
We're talking about complimentary football all the time, but I think it's a little bit deeper than that. Defense went out, forced a turnover, gave the ball to the offense. It's now the offense's responsibility to pay that off for them, to show respect to them. Hey, you guys got some turnover. We appreciate it. They want to continue their drive.
Short completion, just 4 yards, and it's second down. Back to throw again. Body
his safety valve here. That's complete. It'll go as a gain of four. And now that sets up third and two. No score after one on EA Sports. In motion left comes Brown. Trying to run for it with Jacobs. And he will have the first down before he's brought down at the three. They're able to convert with a gain of four. First and goal, a chance to convert that early turnover into points. Jacobs will score. Touchdown, Raiders. A solid blocking up front from the guys on the offensive line allowed him to get in for the touchdown.
Yeah, some might say that the guys on the offensive line were in concert. I used to have a coach who called it marrying up, meaning when you get on a guy, you just stay right there. Each guy has his own assignment that allowed them.
And it's intercepted at the goal line. Picked off by Roquan Smith.
He's already got Roquan.
Jesus. Well, there's some excitement, right? Going for two. Instead, it gets picked off. And how about the return? Give him a lot of credit, though, for not giving up after the play.
Yeah, the troops rallied.
Exactly. And getting back there and making the tackle and not giving up 2 points themselves.
It's a short kick taken out beyond the 20. And a pretty slick return there. Almost got it to the 45. Officially, they'll call him down at the 44.
That's the kind of return you're looking for. To get into that spot on the field, that allows you to do a lot of things on offense.
The Eagles offense set to begin their next drive. And through an interception the first time they had the football, wound up leading to a touchdown the other way. How do you approach drive number two?
Going back to your game plan coming in, everyone has matchups that they like better than others, where they think they have an advantage. Dial up some of those plays. Try and go to those spots and get your offense moving.
Second down and back to Tomlinson. And he'll take it down shy of the 45 at the 46. 4 yards the pickup, first down.
It's nice every now and then in this game not to see people overthink it. Just hand it to the old reliable guy, let him pick up the first down.
Set on first and 10. And they're going to stop him right at the line of scrimmage. Just no cutback lane to be found whatsoever. Second and 10.
The running lanes have definitely not been there for him here in the first half, and I don't think it's all been his fault. His offensive line hasn't given him much space. A loss results there.
Jackson flush to his right, airs it out toward the corner of the end zone, and
it's a good one.
Incomplete. Tried to dial up the long one way out there, but it'll be third down.
That was not a real confident throw right there, and he's just 2 of 7 to start the game. Now he's gonna have to find a groove with a big third down coming up. Let's see if his confidence can increase.
Third down, Jackson swinging this ball out here to Tomlinson. And they're going to get this down near the 35-yard line. It's an Eagles first down on a gain of 11. And we've hit the 2-minute mark in this first half of action. Ball up to the 35 now as they come up on first and 10. Now it's Jackson. A right side catch by Crabtree. And all the way inside the 15 before they drop it. A good pickup there, 22. Here's a first and 10 at the 14-yard line. Tomlinson up the middle. And he's taken down at the 7 after a gain of 7.
Even though they gave up more than they wanted to on that play, it actually illustrates how well they bottled him up throughout the game, because that was his longest run of this contest.
throwing on second and three. Jackson.
Oh, come on. That shit was late.
Late flag comes in. And the contact may have come too early. So now then, the penalty's got him set up with a first and goal. Jackson from the shotgun. And this is caught. Touchdown, Philadelphia. Michael Crabtree from 4 yards out. And the Eagles are an extra point away from capturing the lead. And all about timing there on that short slant, Charles.
Exactly right. That was timed up so well. The route, the throw, touchdown.
Extra point splits the uprights. And they take the lead here at 7-6. Ready, and here we go as he sends this one away. Fields this way up at the 17. And he'll be out of bounds here, a yard shy of the 25 and the 24. Set to get this drive started. There was still more than a minute to go in the half. Time to try to mount a drive.
And I would think that they would have to. This is today's NFL. You got to push it whenever you get an opportunity. You can never have enough points with the high-powered offenses that you face. And analytics will tell you, try and score when given the opportunity.
And he slips up past the 45 before being tackled. Back-to-back good plays have him on the move on first down. And he is met quickly in the backfield. Down he goes, folded like a lawn chair. He'll lose a yard there, and it's second and 11. From the gun, here's Fields. Targeting more, and he's got him on the crossing pattern. And he is out of bounds, but not before he's inside the 30. That one good for 26 and a first down. Operating from the gun, Fields letting one go deep for the end zone. And that is caught. Touchdown, Raiders. DJ Moore, as the first half is winding down. And the Raiders have taken the lead here in the final stages of this first half. Fields trying to throw for it. This is caught. Was he in? Yes. 2 points. And I guess that makes up for the earlier missed 2-point try here to get him to 14.
Yeah, that aggressiveness reminds me a lot of when basketball first adopted a 3-point shot. People are starting to realize that 3-for-2 was really starting to work for them. In this case now, maybe the 2-for-1 is coming into play in the NFL.
So not much time to speak of remaining in this first half as the kick's away. It's a short kick taken out beyond the 20. And they've got it up past the 35, so pretty good starting field position. The Eagles offense set to begin their next drive. And with time quickly fading here in the second quarter, not sure how Jackson hit.
Get it. Go. Good shit. Needed that. Nah, come on, bro. We got another half to play, bro. I played from behind. Come on now. Really? Why do people quit, bro? Like, shit, I fought myself back in being down 40 points. These motherfuckers get mad as soon as they get a turnover, they rage quit. 10,000 coins. We grinding now. Probably what I should have been doing. Let's get back to the playoffs, man. We got it. We got this shit. I feel like this scheme is it. Just gotta figure this shit out. I'm probably gonna need that Derwin James or something, you know, like. Derrick Henry be pretty tough, I ain't gonna lie.
With Charles Davis,
another stack team, bro.
Charles, you talk about story.
How am I gonna defend Casper and Megatron? You guys are fucking kidding me. What did I do to deserve this, EA? Why are y'all matching me up with stack teams? This is hell. I'm gonna remain zero money spent. I'm not giving them no money to buy any of that shit. You can try to, you know, entice me and match me up with these. Like, how'd that dude, like, start off in his own off the gate? You see this shit? Like, he's automatically in the zone. That's crazy.
Fields gonna throw right away.
Lock him up, Gilmore. Lock him up.
Talented team of defending the perimeter and taking away throws to the outside. Great confidence, great skill.
To throw on second and 10. Fields flushed out right. Now he's going to throw deep right side.
Oh my God! Drop. Are you fucking kidding me?
But he gets a reprieve. It's third down.
Bro. That's the guy still in the zone. That's wild. Fuck! Come on, Gilmore. I got you, bro. Faith in you. You can win one of them. Good fucking adjustment. Good adjustment. Trying to beat him. Be smart. If I can lock Gilmore up, I mean, what's his name? Oh, that should be fine.
But here's the thing for me. I'm just wondering if their game plan is incorrect. You know, I think they felt like they could come in and throw it around pretty well.
Uh-oh.
Interception early. They may rethink.
Good shit.
It's a good play there for Vegas. 45 yards.
And as you saw right there, this is a guy with pretty good speed for a tight end. Nice job there catching the short throw and turning it upfield. He could also be a weapon downfield as well.
So how about that for a chain mover? They're all the way down inside the 40 now for first and 10. And some space here.
Good shit. Forgot about the quarterback, I see.
Just a spectacular run by the always dynamic Justin Fields. And the Raiders use the early turnover to get on the board first here in this one. They'll look to throw. And that is going to be caught. And it moves the lead to 8-0.
Good job.
Goal line, especially on two-point tries, sometimes the QB's best friend is that big target, the tight end.
I love how you described it, because you know he's going to have some length and some catch radius, as well as a big body to keep people away from the football.
And not much on this one. Takes it from the 21. And they've got it up past the 35, so pretty good starting field position. Set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense. But not an ideal way to end their previous drive. They threw the interception, Charles, after they had built up some momentum. They were moving the football, but something to at least fight for. And this is caught. It's caught indeed.
I got to keep. What's his name over there?
Here for Dallas. 47 yards.
Well, partner, that's how you make a long drive suddenly. Not so long anymore. One big play, and they're already in field goal range with designs on getting more than that.
Back to throw. Fields. Again, it's Johnson. And they're going to get this down inside the 15.
The goal of a
wide receiver screen is get enough blockers in front to create a wall and let him pick his spot to run the football. How about the defense there swarming to it and not allowing that to happen? Did not let him get downfield.
Now Fields.
Good user.
It's intercepted at the goal line. Picked up by Tremaine Edmonds, the linebacker. And the Raiders are going to take over.
I'm kind of getting used to it now. My adjustments, I'm getting better with them.
Obviously, Charles always costs you, but man, when you throw those interceptions in the end zone like that, it really stings.
He tried to fit that one into his tight end, and I often use the expression NFL open, which means a tighter window. Down near the goal line, you really want to be open. In this case, it cost him.
They'll give him 4 yards there, and it's second down.
I know sometimes we can get fooled when we watch him make catches, as we just saw him do there, because he really looks like a wide receiver the way he goes about his business.
Yeah, we got enforcer,
not super huge,
rusher, pick artist,
to be that inline point of attack
lurker on the body. He got nothing else that I'm worried about. I'll take the half the ball.
You can make him a primary target, and that's how he'll shred the defense.
Second down, Jacobs. And that gets him a little room as he'll take this up over the 10-yard line. So they just need 1 yard here to pick up the first down. On third down, here comes Jacobs.
He ain't got no run shed.
He's up to the 14. Final 30 seconds of this first quarter. And it's been a quarter dominated by the guys with the football. Had a bit of a lane there, took advantage of it. Give him 7 there on the first down carry. Now a timeout called for by the offense. They'll have 2 remaining as we step aside here in this first quarter. Throwing on 2nd and 3, Fields. Throw over the middle into the hands of the tight end Parham. And he's going to be marked down just inside the 35.
Love when they try to use her those deep routes. Give me them checkdowns I like.
Play there for Vegas. 45 yards. On first down, Fields. And he's going to hook up with his big tight end, complete. He'll get it inside the 20. And they'll have it in the red zone before he crosses over.
Bro, I went out of bounds. Are you fucking kidding me? Wow.
So the ball down to the 16 here for 1st and 10.
Well, still, though, I mean, whatever.
Fields now to throw. Eluding the pressure right. And he'll protect himself at the end here as he winds up getting pretty decent yardage. To throw again on 2nd down. Fields. And this throw incomplete. The defender all over in that time, and it's going to lead to 3rd down.
Well, no one likes to see that drop, but I'll guarantee it's not going to stop his quarterback from going back to him anytime he has open space.
And this time he's got the hookup. It's complete. On 4th down, Fields. And he's going to have his running back. It's complete.
Shit.
Yards away, and the Raiders go 98 yards and finish it off in the end zone. They'll try and throw for it, and that's going to be knocked away.
Was that even inaccurate pass?
Incomplete. Well, split the difference, and they're right where they would have been with 2 PATs. They got the 2-point conversion the first time. They failed there.
What's up, Justin?
Because the first time you go after your first score, that feels like a gamble. The second time
done. Bro, get you a Keanu Neal, bro. Get you one. This shit is clutch.
About set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense. And it's been a miserable start for them offensively. Obviously, 2 drives, 2 interceptions.
And this is where you have to know your quarterback.
Good user adjustment. God damn it. Fuck. Trying to defend that fucking 91 Megatron car. That shit's hell. And I'm putting the right zone on the field.
on first and 10. Here's Fields.
Take a crosser. Come on, Gilmore. I trust you. I trust you, Gilmore. Good fucking shit, Gilmore. Good shit, my guy.
On second down, he finds his man Johnson, and he is out of bounds inside the 35. This offense finding its legs now. Here's another first and 10 to throw his Fields.
He lets come on, Gilmore, 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 give me the fucking user. There we go. Lock him up, Gilmore. That's what I need.
And it'll bring up second down.
Another dangerous throw there, partner. I mean, throw two interceptions here in the first half. I don't know if you
want to
keep
it. Lock Megatrono. We gonna buy you some.
Kind of lack of success.
Yeah, absolutely. Very well could have been a third interception.
Lock him up. Lock him up, Hayes. Lock him up. Let's go.
This is going to be intercepted. And the Raiders are going to take possession here. It's a touchback.
I'm not going to let you moss me, bro. Not going to be that type of game.
I'm not sure that the wheels, Charles, are coming completely off, but they're shaking a little bit. That's three interceptions, and now interceptions here on back-to-back drives.
And I think about what a Hall of Fame coach told me, that he always told his teams, when a mistake happens, just move on to the next play.
Gotta get those little quick completions.
This many interceptions, that's exactly the attitude that has to be adopted.
All right, he's out wide.
Looking to throw again on second down. Fields. And he's going to have to eat this one as down he goes.
I missed that escape artist that I've been using in that field of fear, but. Just got to make him adapt.
Here's Fields. Got a man and he hits
get that first. Get out of bounds. Good shit.
And he'll have this past the 30 prior to going out of bounds. 14 yards is the pickup there at a Raider first from the 32 now. Here's first and 10. Now Fields. Again to the big tight end.
Shit.
And they get him down, but not before he takes it.
Trying to get this quarterback in the zone, so it's a problem for him.
For him on that one. He's been a busy man. It's a first down. Creeping up on a minute to play in this first half. His throw complete right side of the tight end Parham. And they're able to work this across midfield to the 48. A good position to be in here, second and inches. Fields.
All right, we in the zone.
Quick hitter here, it's complete. And he'll go out of bounds after taking it a little further down inside the 40. Jacob's going to try the middle.
Good shit.
A pickup of 10, and it's enough for a Las Vegas first down. Now the Raiders.
How was that not a 10-yard run?
And final timeout. As they'll stop it with a little over 30 seconds to go in the first half of play. Fields on first down.
Oh, they highlighted him early. I love that pro reads.
Touchdown, Raiders. Donald Parham, 29 yards. And the Raiders will extend their lead in the final minute.
He calling for the ball as soon as I snapped it. He was like, blah, 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 blah. I'm open. I'm like, all right, bro, I'm going to throw it to you.
Great word, partner. Use a barrage right there. I'm going to add another word if you don't mind. How about perfection? No surprise that they're leading right now. Absolute dominance throughout this ball game, and no signs of slowing down.
Good shit. We dominating, baby.
It's good. And that extends their lead by
he got a tough team, bro. I ain't going to lie. He got that Megatron 91. Gotta make sure I play the right zone on it, get on my user on him, lock him down so I don't get mossed. And he got me like two times, but I mean, for the most part, it can be defended. It's like nothing's completely OP if you know what you're doing offensively.
About set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense. And with time quickly fading here in the second quarter,
hit him. Good pressure, good pressure. Let's take him out of the zone. As long as he don't get the ball, he's going to get knocked out.
In this situation, if they decide to take a shot.
Here's second and 10 now from about the 32. Out of the gun, Fields. escaping the pressure right. On the run.
As long as you don't get it, we good. Good pressure.
Here. They were hoping for the home run play to get
him in the zone over there. Let's go. Hey, said, let me get it. Hey, said, let me. I dare you to throw it. He in the zone, bro. Ah! Come on, Ace. Damn. Megatron, he held.
A final shot before the break. Fields.
Hey, he said, give me that back. Hey, he said, give me that back. Good stick. Hey, he's clutch for my defense right now. Maxed him out. First legend. They're like, people want to throw the ball. You know, I got a safety net. What just happened? Did he rage quit at halftime? That man rage quit at halftime, bro. Good defense. That should be 2-0. So we beat two stack teams with defense is pretty good. Like if you look at what we're allowing, and you know, first game I think he played it out. Second game he quit at halftime and he had Megatron. Some of these people get these overpowered cards and don't even know how to fucking play, bro. You gonna keep it going, fellas.